Hello students, in this lecture we are going to see the second chapter on in optimization technique, which is decision analysis and games. Now let's see the introduction. So the theory of game or competitive strategies is the mathematical theory that deals with general features of competitive situations. This theory is useful when two or more individuals or organization with conflicting objectives try to make decision. In such a situation, decision made by one decision maker affects decision made by one or more decision makers, and final outcome depends on the decision of all parties. Such a situation often arises in the field of business, next industries, sociology, military training, etc. So the theory of game based on minimax principle, maximin principle, put forward by J.von Neumann, which implies that each competitor will act so as to minimize his maximum loss or maximize his minimum gain or achieve best of worst. Now we'll see the characteristics of game. What are the characteristics of game? Now first, there are finite number of participants or competitors. If number of participants is 2, then game is called 2-person game. For number greater than 2 is called n-person game, right? So for example, for in game, in cricket there are 11 number of players, okay? So in if we play chess, then it has 2 players. So here there are finite number of participants or competitors. If number of participant is 2, then we call this game is 2-person game, and the participant more than 2, then we call it as n-person game. Okay, so second one, each participant has available to him a list of finite number of possible courses or action. So the list may not be same for each participants. Third one is, each participant knows all the possible choices available to others but does not know which of them is going to be chosen by them. Next one is, play is said to occur when each of the participant chooses one of the courses of actions available to him. So the choices are assumed to be made simultaneously so that no participant knows choices made by others until he has decided his own. Next one, fifth, every combination of courses of action determines an outcome which results in game to the participant. So the gain may be positive or negative. Gain. So positive, negative or zero. So negative gain is called loss. And here positive gain means what? Which is income. So zero gain means what? No loss and no income. So here sixth one is, the gain of participant depends not only his own action but also those of others. So next, seven number characteristics of game is the gains payoff matrix. So for each and every play are fixed and specified in advance and are known to each pair. Thus each pair knows fully information contained in the payoff matrix. And last characteristic is, the player make individual decision without direct communication. Now we'll see the game model. What is the game model? So there are various types of game models. They are based on factors like number of players participating, the sum of gains or losses, and number of strategies available, etc. Now let's see the number of persons. If a game involves only 2 players, it is called 2-person game. If there are more than 2 persons, it is called n-person game. N-person game does not imply that exactly n players involves. Means what? It may imply 3 players, 4 players, and if more than 2 players, then we say that it is n-player game. Okay. So in it, rather, it means that participant can be classified into n mutually exclusive group with all members in a group having identical interest. Now what is meant by sum of payoff? So sum of payoff means if the sum of payoffs, which is gain or losses to the player, is zero, so the game is called zero sum or constant sum game. Otherwise, it is called non-zero sum game, right? So if the sum of payoffs, which is gain or losses to the player, is zero, then game is called zero sum game or constant sum game. Otherwise, it is called non-zero sum game. Now, next, number of strategies. What is mean by number of strategies? So the number of moves or choices for each player is called number of strategies. Okay, so if number of strategies, which is called moves or choices, is finite, then the game is called finite game. If not, then it is called infinite game. So now actually we'll see the game. So what is mean by a game? It is an activity between two or more persons. Like if we play chess, then it has two players. Okay, so it is an activity between two or more persons involving action by each one of them according to set of rules, which results in some gain. So what is meant by gain? Which is positive, negative, or zero for each. If in a game actions are determined by skills, it is called a game of strategies. If they are determined by choice, it is called game of a chance. And a game may be finite or infinite. So a finite number of moves and choices, while on infinite game, game contains infinite number of choices. Okay, now what is mean by player? So let's see the definition of player. Each participant or competitor playing a game is called player. Each player is equally intelligent and rational in each approach. So in short, every player has an its own action. So participant or competitor playing a game is called player, and each player is equally intelligent and rational in each approach. Next, what is mean by play? See the definition of play. A play of game is said to occur when each player chooses one of his courses of action, right? A play of game is said to occur when each player chooses one of his courses of action. Now the next definition is strategy. So what is strategy? It is the predetermined rule by which player decides his course of action from his list of courses of action during game. To decide particular strategy, so the player need to know other strategies. So this is called strategy. And next, what there are two types of strategies. So first, pure strategies and mixed strategies. So what is pure strategy? It is decision rule to always select a particular course of action. It is usually represented by number in which course of action associated. And second one is mixed strategies. So what is mixed strategy? It is decision in advance all players to choose course of action for each play in accordance with some probability distribution. Thus, mixed strategy is selection among pure strategy with some fixed probability proportion. So the advantage of mixed strategy after pattern of game has become evident is the opponent, which is competitors, are kept as guessing as to which course of action will be adopted by the players. Next, we will see the optimal strategy. What is mean by optimal strategy? So the strategy that puts the players in the most preferred position irrespective of strategy of his opponent is called an optimal strategy. So any deviation from this strategy would reduce his payoff. Okay. So the second one is zero sum game. What is zero sum game? It is the game in which sum of payment to all the players after the play of game is zero. This is called zero sum game. In such a game, gain of player that win is exactly equal to the loss of player that is tie. Then we say that this is zero sum game. That is so loss and gain will be equal. Then we say that this is zero sum game. Now, for example, two candidates fighting election, where in gain of votes by one is the loss of votes by other. This is the zero-sum game. Means one of them is them getting loss and other getting gain. Okay. Now, next one is two-person zero-sum game. It is game involving two players in which two gain of one player equal to the loss of other player. Okay. It is also called the rectangular game or matrix game because the payoff matrix is rectangular in the form. So if there are n players and sum of game is 0, then it is n person zero sum game. Okay. Now let's see the characteristics of two person zero sum game. So what are the characteristics? First, only two players are involved there. Okay. Second one is each player has finite number of moves or strategy to use. Third one is each specific strategy results in payoff matrix. And last one is total payoff to the two players at the end of each play is 0. Okay. And next we'll see non-zero sum game. So here a third party receive or make some payment. A payoff matrix for such a game is known is shown below. So the left hand entry in each cell is payoff 2A and RHS entry is payoff 2B. So here each entry is in left hand. So this is payoff to A, payoff matrix to A, and this is for payoff matrix to B. And here is 1-1 position 2-2. 1-2 position has value minus 6, 6. 2-1 position has value 6, minus 6. And 2-2 position has value minus 2, minus 2. In this case, here addition of these two player is 0. So 6 minus 6 will be 0. Here minus 6 plus 6 again 0. But 1-1 position and 2-2 position is not 0. So here 2 plus 2 which is 4 not equal to 0. And here after taking addition minus 2 minus 2 which is minus 4 again not equal to 0. So note that for play combination 1-1 and 2-2, the sum of the players are not equal to 0. Okay. Only 1-2 position and 2-1 position we get here. Sum of play is 0. So what is payoff? It is the outcome of playing game. Payoff matrix is the table showing the amount received by the players named at the LHS. So this is the amount received by players A, called we named it as, it is at left hand side. After all possible plays of the game, the payment is made by players named at the top of the table. So let player A have m courses of action and player B have n courses of action, then the game can be described by the player of matrices which can be constructed as described below. So this is m by n payoff matrix. So here it has some rule. First is row designation for each matrix are the courses of action available to the player A, right? So row designation for each matrix are the number of courses of action. So these are number of courses of action 1, 2, 3, 4 up to so on m. So this is for player A strategy and this is for player B strategy having n number of columns. So 1, 2, 3 up to so on n number of columns. Okay. Second one is column designation for each matrix are the courses of action available to the player B, right? So this is the courses of action available to player B. And third one is the cell are the payment to A for one matrix and B for the other matrix. So the cell entry Aij is the payment to A in A's payoff matrix when A chooses the courses of action I and B chooses the courses of action J. Means what? If we choose Aij values, so I is the value for players A and J is the values for player. So I is values for player A and J is the values for player B. Okay. And next D is in a two-person zero-sum game, the cell entries in the B's payoff entry will be negative of the corresponding cell entries in A's payoff matrix. So A is called maximizing player and feud try to minimize or maximize the gains, while bees called minimizing players as feud try to minimize the loss. So this is the A's payoff matrix. So this is the player A. So this is course of action for player B, and this is course of action for player B, and these are the values for the particular position. This is A11, so ij position is 11, 12, 13 up to so on 1n. So these are am1, am2, amn up to so on last amn. So this will be m by n matrix. Okay, so this is A's payoff matrix. Now we'll make B's payoff matrix. So this is positive a11, a12 up to so on a1n and so on. So all the values are positive, and we make B's payoff matrix, which is negative, such that addition of these two matrices will be 0. So position of A11 will be 0, position of A12 0. So all position will make 0 for making B's payoff matrix. So make it. So here this is the B's payoff matrix. So in A's payoff matrix, we have seen all values are positive, and here B's payoff matrix, all values are negative. So here, so the sum of payoff matrix A and B is a null matrix after adding these two matrix after position. So here in A's payoff matrix, we have values of at position 11 is A11, here minus A1. After adding this, you will get 0. Again, after adding A's payoff matrix and B's payoff matrix, we get here null matrix. Means what? All the entries will be 0, because in A's payoff matrix, we have all positive values, and in B's payoff matrix, all values are negative. So this is null matrix or zero matrix. Okay. So the here objective is to be determine the optimum strategy of both the players that results in optimum payoff to each irrespective of the strategy used by others. Now we'll see the example on A's and B's payoff matrix. See the example. Competitor A and B are assumed to be an equal ability and intelligence. So A has choices of strategy 1 or strategy 2, while B can select strategy 3 or 4. So we have given the, so this is competitor A, and here competitor B. We have for competitor A, we have two actions, two choices 1, 2, and here competitor B has choices 3 and 4. We have given it is 4, 6, 3 and 5. Now in this case, we'll choose maximum row. So we have given this value 4, 6, 3, 5. We have given, then we'll choose row minimum and column maximum. So here in this row, here what is minimum between these two? So 4. So we will write here 4. And again in this row, we will find out its minimum. So what is minimum? It is 3. Again, to find out maximum of column, so in this column, so here 4 and 3. So maximum is 4 and here maximum is 6. Okay. So here 1, 2 is the actions for competitor A, and 3 and 4, this is strategies for player B. Okay, and 4, 6, 3, 5 are the given values. This 4 is for 1-1 position, 1-2 position has value 6, 2-1 position has value 3, and 2-2 position has value 5. From that, we will find minimum of rows and maximum of columns. Now, in next example, in a certain game, player A has 3 possible choices, L, M, N, while player B has 2 possible choices, P and Q. Payments are to be made according to the choices made. So choices we have given LP, so the payment is A pays B rupees 3. So LQ is B pays to A rupees 3. MP is A pays to B, and here MQ is B pays to A which is 4 rupees. NP, we have given the course of action B pays to A, and NQ is B pays to A. We know that if A pays to B, then we know that A pays to B, then we get negative values, and if B pays to A, then we get positive value. Okay, so we will prepare the table. Now here they asked, what are the best strategy of player A and B? what is the value of gain for A and B. So we'll prepare the table. So let's prepare the payoff matrix. So here player A has three possible choices. So write down. So this is player A. So player A has choices L, M, N. So player A has strategies L, M, N. And player B has strategies. Player B has strategies. What are the strategies? Player B has two possible choices, P and Q. So player B has only two choices, P, Q. So what we have given? Here we have given LP, choices LP. So here this is L and P, means what? Position for this, which is 1-1 position. So LP is A pays to B. If A pays to B, then here A gets loss and B gets gain. Okay, so we get negative value. So it gets rupees 3. So we get here minus 3. Next LQ. So LQ. So what is LQ? B pays A. So in this case, B getting loss and A getting gain. So A getting gain. So we get here plus 3. Okay. Next MP. So here M and P. So here MP, A pays to B. So again A getting loss. So we take minus. So here whenever you have the condition A pays to B, A pays to B, then you will take negative sign. And if you have B pays to A, then taking positive signs. Okay. Now next one is MP. We have written it as minus 2. Next MQ. So we have B pays to A, which is 4. So which is positive. Next NP. B pays to A rupees 2. We get it is positive. B pays to A. So this is loss of B and gain of A. And last NQ, which is B pays to A rupees 3. So here again positive 3. Okay. Now next we will find out rho minimum. So minimum of rho. Minimum of row, and find out maximum of column. Okay, so here in first row, what is its minimum? So minimum value is minus 3. Minimum value between these two row will be minus 2, and minimum value is 2. Okay, and to find out maximum of column, so in this column, what is the maximum value? So maximum value is 2. So here 2. And what is maximum of this column? Which is 4. Okay. Now next, find out the minimum of maximum of column. So from this column, from this value, we'll find out its minimum. And among this value, we'll find out its maximum. Means what? In minimum, we'll find out its maximum. And in maximum, we'll find out its minimum. So here, therefore, here player A, so 2 is the maximum. So among this minimum, we'll find out maximum. So 2 is the maximum strategy for player A, and among this maximum value, we'll find out its minimum. So again here, this 2 is the minimum strategies for player B. Okay. So here maximum value is equal to minimax value, because here maximum of column is what we have? Maximum of column. What is maximum of column? Which is equal to maximum of column is 2 and 4. And what is minimum of column? Minimum of row, which is minus 3, minus 2, 2. Okay. So among that maximum, we'll find out minimum. Now, minimum of maximum of row, maximum of column is equal to, so minimum of maximum of column, so among this value we'll find out its minimum will be 2, and maximum, so among this value we'll find out its maximum. So maximum of minimum of row, which is equal to, so maximum of this minimum row is 2, so which is again 2. And minimum of this column is again 2. So here, therefore, maximum of minimum of row which is equal to 2 and minimum of minimum max minimax. So this is minimax of column which is equal to 2. That is what we say, maximum value, maximum is equal to 2 and minimax is equal to 2, right? Means what? Maximum is also always for row operation and minimax is for column operation. Therefore, what we get here, maximum value is equal to minimax value because both having same value, then we say that this is stable game, okay? So in this example, we get maximum value is equal to 2 and minimax value is again 2, okay? Because here we have, this is the maximum of column and this is minimum of row. So among this maximum, we will find out its minimum. So minimum of maximum of column is equal to 2. And this row, minimum of row, from this minimum of row, we will find out its maximum. So we get maximum of minimum of row is equal to 2. Therefore, maximum of row is equal to 2 and minimax of column is equal to 2. That is, maximum value is 2 and minimax value is 2. So maximum and minimax value both are same. Therefore, what we say? So here, if in this example, so maximum value is equal to minimax value, this is called value of game. Value of game. So this is equal to V. Okay. If when maximum value is equal to minimax value, then we call this is value of game. Therefore, we get optimal strategy. Okay. If this condition happens, then we say that it is optimal strategy. So a game is called saddle point or equilibrium point, and game is called stable game if maximum value is equal to minimax value. Therefore, value of game will be, so what is value of game? Which is 2, because maximum value is equal to minimax value, both are same. This is called value of game, and value of this will be 2. Therefore, we get value of game is 2, since both values are same. And saddle point is the point of intersection of two courses of actions. So here is 2 value, and here is also 2 values. So here this is maximum minimax value, and this is maximum value. So maximum of minimum, which is 2, and this is minimax value 2. So after taking intersection, we get, so position of this intersection is 3-1. Okay, 3-1, which is N and P. So therefore, game has saddle point at order pair NP, because here N and this P, because after taking intersection of these two values, because here 2 value and a 2, both are same value, so taking their intersection, so intersection made at NP position, therefore NP is the saddle point and value of game is 2. Okay, therefore game has saddle point at order pair NP of the matrix. Okay, we'll stop here. In next lecture, we'll see the example on saddle points. Thank you.